about it first. He said, in every matter of your life, tell the people of God on today to trust me and listen to me before they listen to anyone else in their lives. So I was reading Psalms 37, verse 23 and 24, and I'm getting ready to close. It says, the steps of a good man are ordered by God, so much so that even though he may fall, he will not perish, for the Lord will help him up. I said, that's beautiful, because when I looked at the word, a man's steps are ordered by God. That word ordered literally means refereed by God. It means guided by God. It means sanctioned by God. So that every step I make, God is yet there calling it what it is and teaching me what to do and how to step. And so therefore, since he's with me every step of the way, even though I might fall, I will not perish, because God is right there to help me up. And I thought about that, and I said, well, if all of my steps are ordered or refereed by God, then what really is the nature of a referee? And you know, not to call you out, but you people who are played a little basketball in your lives, understand that a game wouldn't be the same if it did not have a referee. It'd be a little chaotic, if you would, if you didn't have a referee. Whole bunch of fouls going on that have not been called a foul if you didn't have a referee in the game. Well, same thing goes for the game of life, that all of us in here need a referee of our souls. That life just wouldn't be the same if we didn't have a referee on our side. If we didn't have a referee in the game, and just like the referee, God is our referee. And because he's our referee, there's some things he has in common with other referees. One thing is, a referee is the only one that can call a foul a foul. When a referee raises his voice and says, offensive foul, then that means the referee has made the final decision. God is the same way. I know you wanted to judge me when you saw me having that glass of Moscato with my wife at the Italian restaurant, because the bishop shouldn't be drinking. But God said, until I call it a foul, don't you worry about what everybody else is saying. Some little cute girl came in here with a skirt, and it was a little bit above the knees, and some of the people looked at her a little strange. But God said, you keep on walking, because you'll know it's a foul, because I'm going to convict you in your spirit. And don't you worry about everybody else convicting you. And when I convict you, then you change your attire. So the point is that just like a referee, God is the only one that can call a foul a foul. And some of us, truth be told, we're judging on the outside. But there's a thing called traveling, and help me with this. Traveling is when you hold a ball and you take too many steps while holding the ball. There ought to be some dribbling in the midst of them steps. God says, some of y'all have been holding on to a Bible a long time, and your walk ain't what it used to be. You've been holding a long time, but you ain't doing nothing with the word of God. And God calls traveling. And you think, why am I feeling convicted? Why do I feel like I'm uncomfortable sitting down on the bench doing nothing? Because God said he just called a foul in your life. And so when I looked at it, not only then can the referees call a foul, but the referee is the only official that can enforce the rules and sanction a penalty. In other words, I know you wanted to condemn me to hell, but God said, when I call it a blessing, it's a blessing. Whatever my consequences are the consequences. The last thing is, God is the only one that can control the game of life. The referee controls the game. The referee can decide, put some more seconds on the clock. God can decide, he ain't ready to check out yet. Put some more seconds on the clock. Last thing is, as much as you might not like it, a referee's decisions are final. Ain't no sense in you pitching a fit, getting a tech, getting mad. Because whatever the referee said, he's the only one that can overturn it. It's final. God said there's some things I pronounced in your life. No matter how people feel about it, no matter how much you look at it, if I said it, it's a fact. It might not happen today, but if I said it, then he said his word is final. Now, I told you one thing. Here it is, 46 seconds left, but guess what? I'm going to do it. He says, the referee blows his whistle in times of fouls. But I forgot to tell you that when you first got saved, you heard that whistle loud and clear. Truth be told, when you first got saved and then you wanted to go back to something that you just did the last week previous, God said, we worked too hard to get you here. Turn around. Don't call. Don't accept. Go this direction. You heard it loud and clear. But what happened in the last 10 years? It should have been that you were more sensitive to that sound. But now what used to be foul is now. And why? Because we have allowed the crowd to become louder than the referee. When the crowd becomes louder than the referee, you listen to the cheerleaders on the side. And then you listen to the crowd and you listen to the coach. But unless you listen to the referee, you will lose the game every time. Some of us won't listen to the referee until the crowd starts booing us. And if you've ever been booed in here, then you turn to God and say, God, what do you have to say about this? God said, I told you 15 minutes ago, foul. I don't know why you would listen to them in the first place, but God is saying today, listen to his voice. I thought about this whole thing about parables. I said, wouldn't it be wonderful if Jesus were alive walking on earth today? I wonder how he would have taught this concept of listening to God. And I heard God saying, I just need you to go get a referee shirt and a whistle and put it on. I said, what do you mean? So he started feeding me stuff. He started saying, look at the referee, look at what he's on. I said, okay, I got that. I said, but it's still something else. He said, that's the parable. I said, what is the parable? He said, the parable is this. He said, I told you that the referee blows whistles for fouls in order to start or stop a game or for a foul or for a violation. He said, but another thing that a referee blows the whistle for is when a substitute is needed. I said, okay, to work with me. He says, one of the greatest plays of all time involved two teams playing for the souls of mankind. There was team heaven and there was team hell. And he said, and the score made it appear from the very beginning when I created man, it looked like hell was winning. He said, I sent prophet after prophet into the game, but couldn't win for losing. And we were about to give up. He said, but at the fourth quarter of the game, he said, I looked over as a referee and I saw the Holy Spirit beckoning me that he wanted to substitute a player that had been sitting on the bench for a long time. He said, I thought the Holy Spirit was crazy suggesting that we put this player in. He said, but I knew there had to be a method to the madness. He said, so I blew the whistle and said, substitute. He said, all the demons began to tremble. And I couldn't understand why they were trembling. He said, until I saw who came up off the bench was none other than Jesus the Christ. He said, folks thought it was a bad move putting in my only begotten son in the game for the souls of mankind. But it proved to be the smartest move. He said, because when he came in, you know the story, at the last minute buzzer, he scored on Sunday morning. And when he got up, he claimed a victory over death, hell, and the grave. And he said, and because of what he did in that game, you are now on the winning team. Do I have any Team Heaven folks that thank God for substituting his son in the game of life? You wouldn't be where you are today if it were not for Jesus Christ. If God hadn't refereed the game like he had, you wouldn't be able to hear the voice of God, recognize the voice of God, and obey the voice of God.